JFT Just Fair and Direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for April the 28th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, Senior Market Analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded within a narrow range of plus minus 0.10% against the majority of the other G10 currencies. It notably outperformed only AUD, which slid due to Australia's disappointing inflation data, the yen, and the kiwi in that order. The performance in the FX sphere paints a blurry picture with regards to the broader market sentiment, and thus, in order to clear things up, we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world. Here, major EU and US indices ended their trading in the red, with the only exceptions being Spain's IBEX 35, which gained 0.63%, and Wall Street's Dow Jones, which finished virtually unchanged. Appetite improved, but slightly during the Asian session today. Although South Korea's KOSPI fell 1.07%, Japan's Nikkei 225, China's Shanghai Composite, and Hong Kong's Hang Seng gained 0.25, 0.03, and 0.16% respectively. It seems that investors remained reluctant to add significantly to their risk exposure ahead of the FOMC decision later today. At the prior meeting, Fed officials decided to keep all their policy settings unchanged via unanimous vote, noting that bond purchases will continue until substantial further progress has been made towards their maximum employment and price stability goals. As far as the new dot plot is concerned, four members voted for hikes in 2022, while seven members saw rates higher in 2023. But the median dots suggested that interest rates are likely to stay at present levels even in 2023. Even though officials upgraded their economic and inflation forecasts, with inflation now seen at 2.4% this year, Fed Chair Powell clearly said that this will be temporary and would not meet their standards. He also stuck to his guns that it is too early to discuss tapering quantitative easing. So, taking all that into account, we don't expect any policy changes at this gathering, neither a different message by policymakers. Since the previous meeting, data showed that the headline CPI rate jumped to 2.6% year over year, but we expect officials to maintain the view that this will prove to be temporary. However, with other data suggesting that the US economy is recovering from the coronavirus-related damages at a fast pace, especially last week's PMIs, which stood above 60, it would be interesting to see for how much longer the Fed will be able to keep market participants convinced that it is too early to put policy normalization on the discussion table. In any case, for now, with the Fed sticking to its dovish language, we see the case for equities to rebound and drift further north, and for the US dollar and other safe havens like the yen to come under renewed selling interest. Now, apart from the Fed decision, market participants may also pay extra attention to US President Joe Biden's first address to a joint session of Congress 2 days before he notches 100 days in the Oval Office. Biden is expected to talk about his administration's accomplishments so far, but to also outline his vision moving forward. According to the White House press secretary, he will lay out a new $1.5 trillion spending and tax proposal, which, if bodes well with lawmakers, may fuel further investors' optimism. Other priorities Biden may present include more access to healthcare and putting police reforms in place. Now, as for the rest of today's events, besides the Fed decision and Biden's speech, we also get Canada's retail sales for February. Both the headline and core rates are forecast to have rebounded to 4% month over month and 3.7% month over month from -1.1% and -1.2% respectively. At last week's meeting, the Bank of Canada decided to scale back its bond purchases and sounded very optimistic with regards to the economic outlook. So a potential rebound in retail sales is likely to add credence to the bank's view and perhaps help the Canadian dollar to rise further. With regards to the energy market, we have the Energy Information Administration report on crude oil inventories for last week. Expectations are for a 0.659 million barrels inventory build, following a rise of 0.594 million barrels the week before. However, bearing in mind that yesterday the American Petroleum Institute reported a 4.319 million barrels increase, we would consider the risks surrounding the EIA print as tilted to the upside. Tonight, during the Asian Trading Thursday, New Zealand's trading balance for March and the ANZ Business Confidence Index for April are coming out, but no forecast is available for neither release. As for the speakers, apart from Fed Chief Powell and US President Biden, we will also get to hear from ECB President Christine Lagarde. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.